السلام عليكم. محاضرة ثانية موضوع patterns of genetic inheritance. راح نحكي عليها عن autosomal dominant and the autosomal recessive types of inheritance. راح نحكي عن بعض other concepts of non-traditional اللي ما تخضع المندليال pattern of inheritance اللي هي polygenetic inheritance, codominance, incomplete dominance and the sex-linked disorders. The learning objectives of this lecture will be identify the patterns of inheritance of a trait, interpret the human pedigree, understand the genetic basis of selected human autosomal dominant and recessive diseases, summarize polygenetic inheritance, codominance, and incomplete dominance, understand the difference between sex-linked and autosomal diseases, and interpret the human pedigree to determine the sex-linked traits. مثل ما عرفنا بالمحاضرة الأولى أنه the trait يعني الصفة الوراثية governed by certain laws of inheritance. The same laws that apply or the rules that apply for the trait applies for genetic diseases. The genetic diseases results from a change or a mutation in the DNA. طبعا هذا change راح يكون permanent change in the DNA. And it will pass through the gametes from the parents to the offspring. من الآباء إلى الأبناء. Sometimes the parents not have the disease manifestations, they do not show the disease manifestation because the change in the DNA occurred in the gametes without affecting the somatic cells. يعني the mutations صار عند بالgametes, not in the somatic cells, so he will not have the disease, but he will pass it to the offspring. The same rules apply here. If both alleles are needed to produce a disease, then the pattern is said to be autosomal recessive. While if the presence of a single allele is enough to cause a disease, then the pattern is said to be autosomal dominant. The family pedigree, the specialists in genetics, when they study the pattern of inheritance, they construct what we call a pedigree. مثل الشكل برموز يستعملوا لدراسة the patterns of inheritance. And we have certain symbols that we use. For example, the male نستعملها circle, the female نستعملها circle العفو, while the male we use a square. If the person is affected, then السيمبل اللي راح نستعمله حيكون shadowed. If not shadowed, then he is not affected. The horizontal line represent mating between male and female. Vertical line indicate the presence of children. وهكذا احنا كل line represent a generation. هنا راح نشوف هنا بهذا pedigree عندي 4 generations. 1, 2, 3, 4 generation. إذا أنا عندي genotype أقدر أحدد هذا homozygous or heterozygous. Sometimes if I don't know, then I will put a question mark. إذا أنا عندي consanguous marriage or relative marriage, it should be indicated. بعض الأحيان يرمزوا له ب double bar, double bar يعني خطين يحطون. It indicates consanguous marriage. Now we start with the autosomal recessive pattern of inheritance. مثل ما قلنا, in this type, the affected individual must have two recessive alleles in order to have the disease. If I'm having a single gene or a single allele, that makes him a carrier and not an affected person. The carrier can't transmit the disease without having it. يعني إذا أنا عندي two recessive genes, I will have a disease. Single recessive and single, and the other one is normal, then I will not have the disease, but I will be a carrier and transmit the disease. So, we see in the family pedigree of autosomal recessive disease, males and females are both affected. ماكو عندي فرق بيناتهم. The affected person always is homozygous for the recessive allele. He is always homozygous for the recessive allele. If he is heterozygous, يعني عند recessive and another one is normal or dominant allele, then in this case he is a carrier and not affected individual. The chance of having affected babies is increased by relatives' marriage. So if two parents were affected, بيجي حالة خلينا نتخيل إنه both parents were affected by an autosomal recessive disease. يعني اثنيناتهم are homozygous for the recessive alleles. Then 100% of their children will be affected. ما بيها مجال. هو ما عنده أصلاً غير the affected gene. 100% of all their children are going to be affected. If we have a carrier with a carrier, يعني heterozygous with a heterozygous, then in this case I will have possibilities to have affected or a normal or a carrier like the parents. نقدر نحسبها عن طريق البانيت سكوير مثل ما تعلمنا بالمحاضرة الأولى. Will probability of having affected babies increase by having conjugal marriage? We have different diseases and many examples for diseases that are that follow an autosomal recessive pattern of inheritance, like for example galactosemia and other inborn error of metabolism and sickle cell anemia. ما راح ندخل بالتفاصيل مالتها لأنه إن شاء الله بالمراحل الجاية راح سنوات القادمة راح تأخذها بالتفاصيل. Now the other pattern of inheritance is the autosomal dominant pattern. In this case, the presence of a single allele is enough to have a disease. So the affected person is going to be either homozygous dominant or heterozygous. And the homozygous recessive is not showing the disease phenotype. لما راح نشوف هنا أنا. So I'm having three generations, first, second, third generations. Males, females are equally affected. The affected person can be, طبعا أنا ما عندي بهذا pedigree, ممكن هذا الشخص يكون autosomal homozygous يعني إذا أنا أعرف genotype مالته. So he's either homozygous for the dominant allele or heterozygous. Homozygous for the dominant allele or heterozygous. ما عندي carrier state. The only normal person is when I'm having homozygous for the recessive allele. الشيء اللي لاحظه فرق بينه وبين ال recessive إنه هنا أنا عندي in each generation an affected individual. بالfirst, بالsecond, بالthird. بينما نلاحظ بال recessive ما عندي two generations without having an affected individual. هذا الشيء ممكن نشوفه بال recessive pattern of inheritance ونسميه skip generation. We have examples of diseases that follow autosomal dominant pattern of inheritance like Marfan syndrome and osteogenesis imperfecta. Now, what do we mean by polygenic inheritance? A polygenic trait is the one that is governed by more than one set of alleles and possibly present on different chromosomes. حكينا عليها قبل اللي هي autosomal patterns اللي هي whether dominant whether recessive. Now كل حالة كان عندي gene single gene يسوي لي المرض وبي two alleles. Okay. But if I'm having a trait or a disease that's caused by more than one gene present on different chromosomes and each of these genes have different alleles. And in this case, we have what we call a polygenetic inheritance or multifactorial inheritance. The dominant allele in this case will have a quantitative effect. يعني واحد يزيد الثاني. Additive effect. تتجمع التأثير مع عدد الجينات وتساهم في ظهور الفينوتايب of the disease. Many examples of traits that are covered by polygenetic inheritance. For example, height, skin color. And in this pattern of inheritance, the environmental factor is very important and plays a modifying role. For example, the height of the individual is affected by the nutritional state. إذا أنا الطفل يولد هو عنده هاي الجينات, multiple genes that control his height. But he has poor nutrition and malnutrition during early childhood and infancy. He will not achieve the height that he is supposed to achieve. So it's modified by environmental factors. Many of the human diseases such as diabetes, schizophrenia, hypertension, ischemic heart disease are in fact controlled by polygenetic inheritance. احنا نسميها دائما نقول هذا عند استعداد وراثي عائلي. هو بالحقيقة ما عندي في جين محدد. Multiple genes with an additive effect one over the other. And also it's modified by environmental factors. So they are called multifactorial trait. Because ما عندي أكثر من عامل راح يتأثر الجينز والانفيرومنت اثنيناتهم يتدخلون في إظهار الديزيز فينوتايب. Now what about incomplete dominance and co-dominance؟ احنا قلنا بالdominant pattern of inheritance أنا عندي أما هذا اللي الdominant allele إذا موجود راح تطلع عندي الديزيز فينوتايب، وما راح تفرق لي إذا كان homozygous dominant وO أو heterozygous. Okay. بحالة الـ incomplete dominance for certain types of disorders نانا راح يطلع لي الـ heterozygous individual حالة وسطية ما بين الشخص الـ homozygous dominant والـ homozygous recessive اللي هو normal person. Okay. So when the heterozygous individual has intermediate features between the two homozygous, then in this case we call it incomplete dominance. يعتقد انه نانا مثل الدوزج إفكت يسموها، إنه كل جين هو بالحقيقة طلع لي certain types of enzymes or protein or a receptor، فإذا أنا كمية النقص راح يصير عندي أو الزيادة بيها يفرق ما أنا عندي two genes involved or a single gene involved. خلنا نأخذها على مثال عشان تكون واضحة عندنا. We have a disease we call it familial hypercholesterolemia. Okay، اللي تكون عندي بيه زيادة عالية جدا بالكوليسترول. This disease is an autosomal dominant disorder. Autosomal dominant disorder. معناته إذا أنا عندي single allele, it's enough to have a disease. It's enough to have a disease. The disease results from a defect in the gene that codes for the low density lipoprotein receptor. The receptor for LDL. هاي الريسبتر مسؤولة عن إنه تاخذ الكوليسترول من الدم وتوزديه للتشو. فمن راح ينقص الليفل مالت ال LDL ريسبتر، ايش راح يصير عندي؟ زيادة بالكوليسترول بالدم. ممكن هذا الكوليسترول يترسب بالجلد، ممكن يترسب بطانة الأوعية الدموية، يسبب لنا اثيروسكليروسيس، يسبب لنا اسكيميك هارت ديزيز. نلاحظ بهذا الديزيز إنه النورمال انديفيدوال with normal level of cholesterol while the homozygous individual have a very high level of cholesterol. The heterozygous individual راح يكون عنده intermediate features with intermediate level of cholesterol. مما ينتج عنه انه ال homozygous individual will have a severe manifestation of ischemic heart disease ويجوز يصير عنده جلطة وذبحة قلبية at very early childhood. بينما ال heterozygous لا ممكن يعبر لل third decade of life بالثلاثينات بالأربعينات يلا تظهر عنده هذه manifestations. So the features is going to be different whether homozygous or heterozygous. This is what we call the incomplete dominance. Now we come to what we call the co-dominance. Co-dominance occurs when both alleles are equally expressed in a heterozygous person. احنا نعرف انه هو when I'm having heterozygous persons يعني معناتها dominant allele and another allele اللي هو recessive واحد يكون سائل على الثاني. هنا لا اثنيناتهم حيكونون dominant and both are fully expressed. Both are fully expressed. The best example for that is the ABO blood group system. The ABO blood group system. We have both alleles. We have allele for the A blood group and allele for the B blood group. When those alleles are present together in a heterozygous individual, then they are fully expressed and the person is labeled as AB blood group. AB blood group. طبعا ال ABO blood group system is covered by, in fact, the gene that controls this inheritance is covered by three alleles. Not just two alleles. One of them codes for the A blood group, and one of them is code for the B blood group, and they are both dominant. Okay, and we have a small I اللي هي ترمز إلى recessive pattern of recessive allele اللي ما راح يطلع لي بلا A ولا B antigen. Okay, so For a person with blood group A, I will have two possibilities. يا أما يكون homozygous for the A or heterozygous. For a person with the blood group B, also two possibilities, homozygous or heterozygous. Blood group AB, and the two alleles are present and they are both dominant. So we call it co-dominance. For a person with the blood group O, اللي ما عنده لا A ولا B antigen, نعم حيكون بهالحالة homozygous for the recessive allele. For the recessive allele. So this is what we call the co-dominance in the ABO blood group system. Now we come to the sex-linked inheritance. حنعرف إنه in our body we have 46 chromosomes مثل ما قلنا arranged in pairs. 22 pair من هذه راح يكون autosomes and the single pair of sex chromosomes. The pair of sex chromosomes ممكن يكون XX if it was a female and XY if it was a male. A sex-linked trait is a trait that's controlled by a gene that is present on a sex chromosome, يعني على X or on Y. Okay? If it is present on the X chromosome, then it is an X-linked gene. If present on the Y chromosome, then it is a Y-linked gene. في الحقيقة هو صح ان هذا التقسيم خالي, but majority of the traits or the genes are present on the X chromosome. It's a large chromosome that contains many genes and control many enzyme products that are essential in our body. Therefore, when we say a sex-linked trait, in most of the time we are talking about an X-linked trait. Okay, so it's an X-linked allele. هنا راح تكون عندي خصوصية بالتعامل مع الـ sex-linked inheritance. أكو فروقات عن الـ autosomal dominant or recessive pattern of inheritance. ليش عندي هالخصوصية؟ Because the male has only a single X chromosome from the mother and a Y chromosome from the father. And هو من راح يستلم الـ sex chromosome ما بيمجال. الـ X comes from the mother and the Y comes from the father. Okay. The female, she receives two X chromosomes. One from each parent, واحد من الأب واحد من الأم. بحيث أن الميل عند single X chromosome, if this X chromosome was involved by a gene that carries a disease, he will have a disease phenotype. Okay? لأنه ما عنده normal contralateral X chromosome. Okay? While the female, طبعا نخلي ببالنا اكو شغله ثانيه مثل انه most of the X-linked diseases in fact they are recessive in type, يعني مو بس متعلقه بالX كروموسوم, they are also recessive in type. So for the male, قلنا ما دام هو عنده single X chromosome, if it was affected, that's it, he will have a disease. For the female, if a single X chromosome is affected but the other one is normal, ايش راح يصير عندنا بهالشي حاله؟ She will be a carrier, مثل ما أني عندي بالautosomal recessive, a carrier state. She must have both X chromosomes involved in order to have a disease phenotype. Okay. Let's take an example, which is the character of color blindness. اللي هو ظاهرة عمى الألوان, red, green, color. This is governed by an allele that's present on the X chromosome. اللي يحكم عليها allele present on the X chromosome. For normal vision, the allele we call it, طبعا هو recessive allele. For normal vision, راح يكون عندي X big B. While for color blindness allele, I will have X small b, since it is a recessive allele. إذا نلاحظ إنه ال female, if she has one big B and one small b, she will be a carrier female without having color blindness. She must have both alleles to be recessive in type, homozygous recessive, in order to have color blindness. The male, if he has 50% 50%, ما عندها حالة carrier state, يا أما having the disease or not having the disease or not having the disease. الشغلة الثانية بتفرق لأنه it differs when the offsprings were whether males or females and the parent who is involved is he the father or the mother. نحن الجنس راح يفرق لي من ال involved الأب لو الأم وشنو جابه ولد لو بنية. هذا حيكون كلش إلى تأثير أنه يظهر disease phenotype or not to be carrier or a normal or affected individual. In this case we see that females unlike the males they can be carriers, okay, so they can pass it to their children. إذن الأم من تكون carrier she can pass the X chromosome to the male of her children and to the females of her children, both of them. But the male, if he is involved by color blindness, خلنا نتخيل إنه male involved by color blindness, if he has son يعني ابنه ما راح يكون بهذا الديزيز. If he, يعني إذا كل أبناء كانوا هم أولاد ما راح يصابون بهذا الديزيز. ليش؟ لأنه he transmit the Y chromosome to his children, to his sons, الأبناء الأولاد الذكور, not the X chromosome. But his daughters, بتشحالش راح يكون there is a chance of 50% of having being carriers for the color blindness trait. So the males cannot be carriers and they have only one X chromosome. So they are either normal or having the disease. They can transmit to their daughters only, not to their sons, because they receive the Y chromosome from their father. And that's why color blindness is rare in females. It's more likely to be seen in male. لأنه قلنا female لازم اثنيناتهم تكونون involved على مود تطلع لها هاي الصفة. Now, if you consider that a normal male have children with a heterozygous female, normal male with a heterozygous female, what would be the chance of having a daughter with color blindness, and what's the chance of having a son with that trait? هاي خلوها إلكم تفكرون بيها وتشوفون شلون راح تجاوبوني على هذا السؤال. A normal male with a heterozygous female, affected male, also another possibility, affected male married to a carrier female. Okay. أنا راح نشوف عندي بالcolor blindness العفو الfamily pedigree نفس الrules apply. I'm having here an affected male and a normal female, affected and a normal female. ونشوف هنا إنه ابنه كان طبيعي. Okay. الfemale شرح تكون هنا الحالة هذه carrier. Okay. هذا الابن حيكون طبيعي وهكذا نقرأ الفاميلي بيديجري. We have many examples for diseases that are caused by X-linked genes. We have Duchenne muscle dystrophy, we have hemophilia A, حساسية الباقلة اللي هي glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency, and many many other diseases that are well known to be X-linked genes. واحدة من أهم الفروقات بين الـ الإكستينكت والأوتوسومال هو أنه حيكون عندي the frequency differs between males and females. The frequency differs between males and females. And thank you.